When I proposed this year's Grandmaster, I'll admit that I expected some resistance because at 60, she will be the youngest Grandmaster ever named. And instead, I got unanimous approval, not just because of her incredible prose, but also because of her role within the community. I am so, so pleased to name this year's Grandmaster, Nalo Hopkinson. In addition to her books like Brown Girl in a Ring, which is amazing, recognizing her lifetime of achievement as a mentor also holds her up even farther as the role model she has been for so many young writers, and especially young writers of color. She will be only the 8th woman, the 2nd person of color, and the 1st Caribbean writer to be named a Science Fiction and Fantasy Writers of America Grandmaster. And she's amazing. But you don't have to take my word for it.
Hey, Nalo. LeVar Burton here, beaming in to add my voice to the chorus of those who are singing your praises, and deservedly so. Nalo, I was a fan long before we met and became friends. You have been and continue to be an inspiration, not simply with the power and the wisdom in your words, but also with the deep and abiding humanity and generosity of spirit with which you deliver your words to us. There's a fine line, in my view, between humanity and divinity, and you dance between them with effortless ease and grace. Congratulations. The Science Fiction and Fantasy Writers of America have done us all proud in selecting you for this high honor. Peace and blessings. I love you.
I am delighted to congratulate SFWA's newest Grandmaster, Nalo Hopkinson. Nalo is a shining beacon in our community and in our genre. She has overcome great adversity and still continues forward with a generosity of spirit that is truly admirable. Her visionary writing has brought a wealth of diversity to our community, and we are grateful. Thank you, Nalo, for being our Grandmaster.
So I picked up this amazing novel before I ever actually visited the city of Toronto, and I was very happy to discover that it is, in fact, a lovely city filled with very lovely people. Not at all like the dystopia that... But that's what speculative fiction is all about. It's about making real places that are not here and people who are not us, and making us care about those places and people. And Nalo Hopkinson does this masterfully. One could even say grand masterfully. It's not a word. I just made that up. We do that too, all the time. Science fiction. Anyway, congratulations, Nalo. You've more than earned this honor. And welcome to history.
Congratulations, Nalo. No one could deserve this honor more than you do.
I am so pleased to see Nalo Hopkinson named as Grandmaster, not only for her wonderful books, even if she did destroy Toronto in Brown Girl in the Ring, not only for her wonderful books, for her subversive, sexy short stories, and for her abilities as a teacher, and just her place in this community. I have a memory of one of my first cons. Nalo, the guest of honor, was sitting on a couch in the lobby with one of my friends next to her and just giving her full time to him. And later that night she went out for sushi with us too, a whole bunch of writers who had nothing to our names yet. And her willingness to spend time and energy on us was something that I haven't forgotten. Congratulations, Nalo.
Nalo, I'm James Beeman, current SFWA Director at Large. I'm also a fellow Black writer, so I know all too well what you've known for years. We are far too few. You were in this business when we were even fewer. And while the mainstream was glorifying Manifest Destiny You were decolonizing our minds. We were not relegated to sidekicks or comic relief, but elevated, the protagonists of our own stories. Because of this, children that look like you and I have gazed up to the stars and dreamt in new ways and new colors. These children, inspired by your example, dare to tell their own tales. We are here, Nalo, and we are growing louder. I am honored and humbled to be given the opportunity to thank you for your contributions. You are much loved, dear big sister. Ashe.
Monica Valentinelli here. What a privilege it is for me to honor you, your stories, and your many accomplishments, both as one of your readers and as a SFWA board member. In addition to being a multi-award winning author, a teacher, an innovator, and a founder of the Carl Brandon Society, you are also a beloved member of the science fiction and fantasy community. I am so pleased to recognize your many accomplishments thus far. Congratulations on becoming a SFWA Grandmaster. May you continue to be a bright light in science fiction and fantasy for years to come.
I'm Lynn Thomas, the co-editor-in-chief and co-publisher of Uncanny Magazine. It has been my honor to publish some of Nalo Hopkinson's short fiction. What I love about Nalo's writing is its immediacy, its warmth, and her ability to find both the humor and pathos when the ordinary meets the fantastic. Her characters are sketched with clarity, fallibility, and a deep understanding of human nature and its foibles. Nalo is not only an extraordinary writer, she is also a committed teacher shaping the next generation of writers in the genre and the center of a community to which she has consistently contributed, even amidst her own struggles. Judging from her food posting on Twitter, she's also a hell of a cook. I am thrilled that she has been named this year's SFWA Grandmaster. Nalo, congratulations from the bottom of my heart.
Hello, Nalo. I hope you realize how many people have been affected by your stories as readers and also writers who have been tremendously inspired by you. I have talked to so many authors from our Caribbean region like me who have mentioned how your stories have lifted them and given them the promise that their own unique flavors of words could be heard. I've talked to so many Caribbean writers of all different genres who were inspired by you to add the fantastic or something ethereal or something bold as they wrote. And it's not just in the Caribbean that you've held up people. In teaching both at university and at workshops across the world, you've passed that same spark on to so many writers from so many different places. And your books and your stories, of course, have brought the Caribbean to an entirely new audience. The Dance of Trinidad's Midnight Robber became real to a whole new audience, and readers discovered such magic in your work. We will never be the same again, thanks to everyone who has savored your rich words, your exquisite worlds, and been forever changed. The generations of writers who have flowered in the space that you created for us, I know, are going to be so happy to hear about this, and I personally am so very excited that you'll be forever recognized as one of our field's essential voices, because I think you truly are.